Hey, it's Mr. Kaczynski here, working through section double C of IXL's Algebra 1 skills. The last video was linear functions over unit intervals, and today we're going to deal with exponential functions over unit intervals. Okay, so we noticed some patterns in linear stuff. Let's see if we can notice them in exponential relationships. All right, so h of x is 8 to the power of x. How does it change from the interval of x equals 1 to x equals 2? So this increase of 1, that's what we call a unit interval. What happens to the function? Let's find out. H at 1 would be 8 to the first power, which is 8. And h at 2 would be 8 to the second power, which is 64. Okay, did it increase by 8? No, it went up by a lot more than 8. In fact, it went up by 56. Okay, did it increase by a factor of 8? Yes. Yeah, it did. Okay, we multiplied it by 8 more. And that's what exponents are. They're repeated multiplication. So that's increasing by a factor of 8. All right, did it increase by 800%? No, remember it only went up 56. And 56 divided by the original, that's how you find percent change. You do subtraction, 64 minus 8 is 56. And 56 divided by 8 is 7. So it actually went up 700%. It definitely didn't decrease. Let's look at this. All right, again, we have this unit interval where x is going up 1. What happens to h of x? Let's try it again. All right, so h at 2 is 1 over 3 squared, which is 1 over 9, and h at 3 is 1 over 3 cubed, which is 1 over 27. Okay, so did it increase? No, it definitely got smaller. Okay, 1/9 times, is 1/27 smaller than 1/9 is what I'm trying to say. Did it decrease by 3? No, it decreased by less than 1. Did it increase at all? No. So what's that leave us with? That it decreases by a factor of 3, okay? Which is kind of like multiplying by 1/3. That's what happened. Okay, so really, I mean, I hope we noticed that this increased by a factor of 8 right here, this 8. And this decreased by a factor of 3 right here. So what do we think is going to happen here? With this unit interval where t is going up by 1, how is that going to change f of t? You can ignore the 5, guys. It really doesn't matter. It's all about that 10 right there. And this is going to increase by a factor of 10. We'll start going a little faster now because I got several examples I want to get through. Increases by a factor of 10. As opposed to this one where we're dividing by 7 to the power of x, this decreases by a factor of 7. It's really that simple. For the majority of this skill in IXL. Okay, so what about here? We're decreasing by a factor of 10 because it's all about the fact that the 10 is being raised to the t power and we're dividing by it. That means decreasing. All right, then we get to this. This is a little bit different because now we don't have, all we have is percents here. So what I'm going to do is rewrite this function like this, and maybe it'll make more sense to us. G of t equals 5 times 1 minus 0.4 to the power of t. All right, so this 0.4 right here is 40%. So that factor right there is less than 1. That means you're decreasing. And how much are we decreasing by? We started with 100% and we lost 40%. on this one, same idea here. I'm going to take this function and rewrite it. H of x equals, we're going to do it like this, 1 plus 0.9 to the power of x. And this 0.9 right here, it's an increase because it's addition. And by 0.9, that's 90%. So it increases by 90%. And this one is kind of like that idea. H of x, I'm going to rewrite it, is equal to 3 times 1 plus 8 to the power of x. And this 8 9 is the growth factor. It increases by a factor of 9, but that's not an option for us. 8 right there is the percent growth. We start with 100% and we're increasing it by 800%. So that's this one. Some might think it's 900%, but remember you started with 100%. You only increased it by 800%. So that's the trickier parts on here, but you don't get to that until closer to the challenge zone. So exponential functions over unit intervals, give it a try. Let me know how it goes in the comments.